Swayam Prabha, Digital India, Educated India.
Hello students, this is Professor Ravin Zugade from Department of Chemistry, Rashtrasant Tukdoji Maharaj Nagpur University. In this module, we will be discussing about coordination chemistry. Outline of this module is, I have divided this module into four lectures. In the first lecture, we will be discussing about introduction to complexes, Werner's theory, and terminology used in coordination compounds. In second lecture, we will be discussing about valence bond theory of complexes and its limitations. In the third lecture, we will discuss about the IUPAC nomenclature of complexes and introduction to chelates. And in the fourth lecture, we will discuss about isomerism in complexes. Starting with the history of the complexes. The earliest known coordination compound, which was known to Indians, Persians, and Egyptians, was alizarin dye. It is basically a chelate of calcium and aluminium with a ligand known as hydroxyanthraquinone. Now, this dye is beautiful brownish red colored dye or compound. Basically, it's a complex. It was known to Indians since 10th century. The first ever scientific report on complexes has been reported in 1597 by a German alchemist, Andreas Libavius. He was carrying out some experiments in a brass vessel, and the experiments were based on use of solution of ammonium chloride, that time known as sal ammoniac, in the presence of lime. What he observed that the brass vessel, when comes in contact with these two compounds, ammonium chloride and lime, a blue colored solution is formed. And this blue colored solution is basically the copper ammonia complex, which is very well known today. It is a blue solution, and on evaporation of solvent, it gives beautiful deep blue colored crystals of copper ammonia complex. This was the first scientific report available in literature regarding the formation of complexes. Other ancient complexes which were known include the 18th century compounds, Prussian blue, which is known as an artist pigment, and second is the potassium hexachloroplatinate. This Prussian blue was used by artists for painting purpose, whereas potassium hexachloroplatinate was used for refining of platinum. Now, those were the days in 18th century when metallurgical advances in the field were going on, and large number of metal extractions were going on, including gold and platinum. And at that time, this hexachloroplatinate was used for refining of platinum metal. But the first systematic study on complexes was reported by French chemist B.M. Tassert. Now, what this B.M. Tassert was carrying out a few experiments in 1798, and he was studying ammoniacal solution of COCl3, cobalt 3 chloride. He found that this compound in ammoniacal solution develops brownish mahogany color, which is what we call it as a reddish brown color, and this mahogany color appears something like this. So it's a beautiful complex synthesized by Tassert in 1798. This complex further was found to have composition COCl3(6NH3), and this complex acted as a basis for the Werner's theory, which we are going to study ahead. But this complex was found to be different from the double salts which were known at that time. Now let us see what is a double salt and what is a complex or a coordination compound. This is basically the comparison between double salt and a coordination compound. Take this example of double salt, which we commonly call as ferrous ammonium sulfate, whereas the coordination compound is potassium hexacyanoferrate. Now if we compare the properties of these two compounds, we'll understand what is meant by a double salt and what is meant by a coordination compound. If we take a double salt, this is formed by mixing ferrous sulfate and ammonium sulfate in a solution. And when the solvent is evaporated, we get beautiful crystals of ferrous ammonium sulfate. Similarly, this potassium hexacyanoferrate can be obtained by mixing the solutions of potassium cyanide and ferrous cyanide. If we mix them together, evaporate the solvent, we will get the crystals of potassium hexacyanoferrate. Now the method of synthesis is same, but when we dissolve this double salt in the solution, it gives test of each and every ion present in it. It gives the test of Fe2 positive ion, it gives the test of NH4 positive ion, it gives the test of sulfate ions. But if we dissolve K4FeCN6 in the solution, it gives the test of K positive ion, but it does not give the test of Fe2 plus or CN negative ions. It means that something different type of bonding is there in Fe and CN in case of coordination compounds, which is not there in normal double salts. That is the fundamental difference between a double salt and a coordination compound. It means that these double salt exist only in the crystalline state and they lose their identity in the solution, whereas the coordination compound, they retain their identity in the crystalline state as well as in the solution form. Secondly, these double salts give test of each and every ion, but the coordination compounds, they do not give test of each and every ion. It means that the double salts have ionic type of bonding, whereas coordination compounds have coordinate type of bonding. We are going to discuss how this coordinate type of bonding is going to take place in these complexes. The first systematic study on complexes and their properties and the bonding in complexes was reported by Alfred Werner in 1893. He was carrying out experiments based on four important complexes: COCl3(6NH3), COCl3(5NH3), COCl3(4NH3), and COCl3(3NH3). Now all of them have a common metal ion cobalt in +3 oxidation state, a common anion 3 chloride ions, and varying amount of NH3 molecules 6, 5, 4 and 3. Now, if we observe this carefully, we'll find that they should give cobalt 3 plus ions and 3 chloride ions. It means that all of them should give 4 ions. But when molar conductance of these complexes was observed in aqueous medium, the values were found to decrease from 395 to 265 to 108 to 0, indicating that this complex has 4 ions in the solution, this complex gives 3 ions in the solution, this complex gives 2 ions in the solutions, while this complex is totally non-ionic, it does not give ions in the solution. Now why is it so? So this was explained by Werner on the basis of Werner's theory. According to Werner's theory, the metal shows two types of valencies, the primary valency and secondary valency. The primary valency, according to Werner, is ionogenic or ionizable type of valency. whereas the secondary valency is non-ionogenic or non-ionizable type of valency. The primary valency is nothing but same as a normal oxidation number of metal, whereas secondary valency is not the oxidation number, but it is equal to the coordination number of the metal. Now, this word was used for the first time by Alfred Werner. According to Werner's theory, the metal has a tendency to satisfy both primary valency as well as secondary valency. The primary valency is satisfied by negative ion, whereas secondary valency can be satisfied by either negative ion or a neutral molecule. The primary valency is variable in number and it is non-directional in nature, whereas secondary valencies are fixed in number and they are directional in nature. It means that metal will satisfy both the valencies either with negative ions or with neutral molecules. For this particular theory, he was awarded with Nobel Prize in Chemistry in 1913. Again, coming to the four complexes which Werner was studying, COCl3-6NH3, COCl3-5NH3, COCl3-4NH3 and COCl3-3NH3. On the basis of these four complexes and observations made regarding the number of ions it is producing, we can explain how Werner's theory beautifully explains the coordination between this cobalt with chloride and ammonia molecules. Consider the first complex COCl3-6NH3. Now, according to Werner's theory, this cobalt has oxidation number +3. It means that the number of primary valencies are 3, whereas number of secondary valencies are 6, which are directional in nature. And all of these secondary valencies as well as primary valencies have to be fulfilled. Out of that, ammonia is a neutral molecule, so it is capable of fulfilling only the secondary valencies and not the primary valencies. Hence, all the 6 secondary valencies are satisfied by ammonia molecules, whereas all the 3 primary valencies are satisfied by chloride ions. Now, since ammonia molecules are satisfying secondary valencies, it is forming the coordination sphere around the cobalt, which is metal ion, whereas chloride ions are outside the coordination sphere, and hence the complex should be represented as CONH36Cl3, whereas this is called as the coordination sphere in the square bracket and 3 chloride ions outside the coordination sphere. And when it undergoes dissociation, only the primary valencies fulfilled by chloride ions are dissociated and secondary valencies fulfilled by ammonia are not dissociated, and hence what we get is a complex ion with 3 counter ions, which are chloride ions. Hence, we get overall only solution. Coming to second complex, COCl3-5NH3. Now, in this complex, we have only 5 ammonia molecules, and we know that the neutral molecules can satisfy only secondary valencies. So, out of the 6 secondary valencies of cobalt, 5 secondary valencies will be fulfilled by or satisfied by ammonia molecules. Now, there is 1 secondary valency left. Now, this is to be fulfilled. But ammonia molecules are not now available. But secondary valency can be fulfilled by negative ion also. So, one of these chloride ions will satisfy the secondary valency. And hence, out of the 6, 5 are fulfilled by ammonia, while 1 is fulfilled by chloride ion. Now we are left with 3 primary valencies. Out of that, 2 are fulfilled by chloride ions, and 1 primary valency is satisfied by the same chloride ion, which is fulfilling the secondary valency. So, 1 of the chloride ions is fulfilling primary as well as secondary valency, whereas 2 chloride ions are satisfying only primary valencies. Hence, the complex should be represented as CONH35Cl in the coordination sphere and 2 chloride ions outside coordination sphere. And hence, when it undergoes dissociation, only 2 chloride ions outside coordination sphere are dissociated. As a result, we get only 3 ions in the solution as observed by Werner while carrying out the experiments based on the concept of ionic conductance or molar ionic conductance. To the third complex, which is green in color, and here there are only 4 NH3 molecules out of this. So out of the 6 secondary valencies, 4 are fulfilled by NH3 molecules, whereas 2 will be fulfilled by chloride ions. Remaining 1 chloride ion will fulfill the primary valency, whereas the 2 chloride ions which are fulfilling the secondary valencies will also satisfy the primary valencies. Hence, 2 chloride ions are satisfying both valencies, while 1 chloride ion is satisfying the primary valency only. Hence, this complex should be represented as CONH34Cl2 in the coordination sphere and 1 chloride ion outside coordination sphere. Hence, when this molecule undergoes dissociation, it gives you 1 complex ion and only 1 counter ion. Hence, there are only 2 ions in the solution, and hence the molar conductance has further decreased. Coming to the fourth complex, which is again green in color, out of the 6 secondary valencies, 3 secondary valencies are fulfilled by the ammonia molecules, while 3 secondary valencies as well as primary valencies are fulfilled by the chloride ions. Now, you will find that all the chloride and ammonia, they are present in the coordination sphere and fulfilling the secondary valencies. The 3 chloride ions are fulfilling primary as well as secondary valencies. Hence, the complex should be represented as CONH3 3 times Cl3 and entire thing in the coordination sphere, that is in the square bracket. Now, there are no ionizable valencies outside the coordination sphere, and hence this complex will not undergo ionization and it will not give ions in the solution, and hence it will have negligible molar conductance. Coming to the experimental verification, we want to experimentally verify whether this Werner's theory can explain the properties of these complexes. Consider the first complex. If we take COCl3, 6NH3, and to the solution of this complex we add some solid silver nitrate and heat it, what we get is, we get 3 moles of AgCl for 1 mole of the complex. It means that 1 mole of the complex is acting as a source of 3 chloride ions. It is clear indication that there are dissociation of 3 chloride ions as explained by Werner's theory, since only 3 chloride ions are present outside the coordination sphere and hence they can undergo ionization, fulfilling the ionizable primary valencies of the complex. Coming to the second complex, where one of the chloride ion is fulfilling primary as well as secondary valency. Now in this case, if we take the solution and add silver nitrate, we get precipitate corresponding to only 2 silver chloride, that is corresponding to only 2 chloride ions. It means that this chloride ion, which is fulfilling the primary as well as secondary valency, is not undergoing dissociation, and hence the complex should be represented as CONH35Cl and only 2 chloride ions outside the coordination sphere which are undergoing ionization in the solution, and hence only 2 chloride ions are formed. Coming to the third complex, where there are 2 chloride ions fulfilling primary as well as secondary valencies and 1 chloride ion fulfilling only primary valency. If we take the solution, add silver nitrate to it, boil the solution, we get a precipitate corresponding to only one chloride ion, that is 1 mole of AgCl is formed for 1 mole of complex. It means that complex is acting as a source for only one chloride ion. Hence, we can say that the complex can be represented as only one chloride ion outside the coordination sphere, giving you only one chloride ion, whereas two chloride ions which are present inside the coordination sphere are not undergoing dissociation at all. Coming to the fourth complex, now in this case, if we add silver nitrate to its solution and boil, we do not get precipitate of AgCl, indicating that there is no chloride ion in the solution, means that all the three chloride ions are present in the coordination sphere and they are fulfilling the secondary valencies. Hence, they are non-ionizable and leading to formation of no ions in the solution. Hence, it means that it's a great success of Werner's theory that it can explain the observable properties of these coordination compounds on the basis of the concept of primary and secondary valencies. The primary valencies which are ionizable and secondary valencies which are non-ionizable. Now, let us discuss some important terminology used in coordination chemistry. Whenever we are going to move forward developing various theories of coordination chemistry, we will come across important terms. The first term which we come across is the central metal ion. Basically, central metal ion is a positively charged metal ion in most of the cases, and it is basically an electron pair acceptor, which is a Lewis acid. Take any metal ion in the coordination complexes like cobalt 3 plus, cobalt 2 positive, Ni 2 positive, copper 2 positive, Ag positive, all of these will be called as central metal ion because they will be coordinated by the ligands or by the donor molecules or donor atoms in a spherical manner, and this metal ion is present at the center of the coordination sphere. Second term which we come across is a ligand. Ligand is generally an ion or a neutral molecule, and it is an electron pair donor. Since it is an electron pair donor, it is classified as a Lewis base. And the common ligands can be anions or neutral molecules. Some common anionic ligands are, this is Cl negative, Cn negative, Br negative, SO4 2 minus. These are the common ligands which are negatively charged, whereas NH3 H2O, they are the molecular ligands which are neutral molecules. Third term is the complex ion. It is a charged species formed by combination of central metal ion and ligand. Consider this cobalt 3 plus is forming a complex ion with ammonia ligand. So 6 ammonia ligands are forming a complex with cobalt 3 plus, forming a special type of ion having a formula CONH36 3 positive. Now this is called as a complex ion. Similarly, platinum 2 positive ion is forming a complex with 4 chloride ions which are ligands. Hence, the combination of central metal ion plus ligands bearing a charge is called as a complex ion. Coordination sphere. Now, it is a sphere which is formed by the ligands around the central metal ion. We know that the metal ion is surrounded by the ligands, and the ligands are forming a sphere around it called as the coordination sphere, and it is generally represented by a square bracket to represent or to show a coordination compound. There is a counter ion. Now the oppositely charged ion which is associated with a complex ion. For example, if we consider this CONH36 3 positive. Now this is a complex ion. Now this complex ion will always be associated with some negative ions so as to make a neutral molecule. So whatever are the oppositely charged ions associated with a complex ion, they will be called as a counter ion. For example, if we put counter ion chloride over here, then the complex will be, or the coordination compound will be CONH3 6 times 3 positive associated with 3 chloride ions. Similarly, if we consider PtCl4 2 negative, then the coordination sphere is PtCl4 2 negative and counter ion will be positively charged ion associated with this complex ion. Then there is something called as a coordination number. It is the number of coordinate bonds which are formed by central metal ion, or in other words, we can say that it is the number of monodentate ligands. We will see what is monodentate, but the number of monodentate ligands which are associated with the central metal ion in a complex, that is called as a coordination number of that metal ion. For example, in the same complex CONH3-6-3 positive, you will find that this CO is associated with 6 ligands and so the coordination number is 6. In this case, platinum is associated with 4 chloride ligands and forming 4 coordinate bonds, and hence the coordination number of platinum is 4. Then what is a coordination compound? It is a neutral compound formed by complex ion and counter ion. Now, if we have a complex ion like this and a counter ion from here, then they combine to form what is called as a coordination compound. We will take an example of this. We will try to understand this terminology with the help of a few examples. First one is this. CONH3-6 times Cl3. Now in this coordination compound, this cobalt is the central metal ion, NH3 are the ligands, Cl3, which are present outside the coordination sphere, they are the counter ions. Cobalt along with the 6 ligands, it is called as the coordination sphere, or it is also called as a complex ion. Now, since this complex ion is positively charged, because cobalt is in +3 oxidation state and NH3 is a neutral ligand, so this complex ion is positive ion, and hence the counter ions are chloride, which are negatively charged ions. The overall combination of central metal ion, ligands and counter ion is called as coordination compound. Another example is K4FeCN6, commonly known as potassium ferrocyanide. Now in this case, the counter ions are positively charged potassium ions. The complex ion is FeCN6 with 4 negative charges and K are having 4 positive charges. Here the central metal ion is Fe. Ligands are cyanide, the counter ions are potassium, and the coordination sphere is the sphere formed by the cyanide ions around the central metal ion Fe. The complex ion in this particular case is a negatively charged ion, and hence the counter ions are positively charged. So we can have complex where the complex ion is positive. We can have a coordination compound where complex ion is negative. Also, we can have a coordination compound where complex ion is neutral. For example, if we consider this CONH3 3 times Cl3, then cobalt is in +3 oxidation state and 3 positive charges of cobalt are neutralized in the coordination sphere itself by the 3 chloride ions, and hence the complex ion is a neutral complex now. So in such type of complex, there are no counter ions. Now what are ligands? We have seen that the ligands are electron pair donor. We classify the ligands as monodentate ligand. So different types of ligands are there. So monodentate ligands are those ligands which can form only one bond with the central metal ion. So they have one electron pair to donate to the metal ion. A bidentate ligand has a tendency to donate two electron pairs to the metal ion, and it can form two coordinate bonds with the central metal ion. Monodentate ligand, we have examples like ammonia, chloride, bromide, sulfate, they are monodentate. Bidentate, this is the example of oxalate ligand. This is having two donor species or two donor moieties in the same molecule. So it is called as a bidentate ligand. Similarly, we can have a tridentate ligand, the ligand which can form three bonds with the central metal. Then we can have a polydentate ligand which can form more than three bonds. Now here we can see that there are three nitrogen donor atoms. Here we can see there are two nitrogen donor atoms and four oxygen donor atoms, O. So it is a basically two nitrogen plus four oxygen is hexadentate ligand, which can form this type of complex with the same metal. This ligand as this ligand are same. You will see this is CH2 ethylene group, then two nitrogen atoms over here forming coordination bonds with the metal, and four CH2COO species. This is CH2COO species. So this type of complex can be formed by the polydentate ligand. Apart from this, there is a special type of ligand called as a ambidentate ligand, or sometimes also called as a ambident ligand. Now this ligand has a tendency to form only one bond, but through different donor atoms. For example, if we consider this NO2 negative, this NO2 negative can form bond through nitrogen or through oxygen. Such ligand will be called as a ambidentate or ambident ligand. To summarize this particular lecture, what we have studied today, that many complexes were known for a long time, but theories on complexes were developed in the 20th century. Alfred Werner was the first to introduce the concept of coordination number and coordinate type of bonding. Complex ions are made up of central metal ion and ligands. Counter ions are associated, which are present outside the coordination sphere. And ligands can form one or more bonds with the central metal ion. This is all about this lecture of introduction to complexes. The remaining part of this we will see in lecture 2, 3, and 4. Thank you. Thank you very much.